Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha sent a proposal of marriage. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha sent a proposal of marriage to the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Abu Talib. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam agreed to this, and the marriage ceremony was concluded between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who was 25 years of age at that time, and Khadija, the mother of believers, the daughter of Khuwailid, who was 40 years of age at that point of time. Let us take a pause, my brothers and sisters. And between Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, who was 40 years of age at that point of time, and the love which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created between the two was exemplary. Even after the demise of Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, years after she passed away, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam remembered her. Whenever he slaughtered an animal, he sent a portion of the meat to the friends of Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. And as long as Khadija, may Allah be pleased with her, was alive, the Prophet did not marry another woman. And all the children that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had, with the exception of Ibrahim, were from the womb of Mother Khadija, may Allah be pleased with her, Al-Qasim, Abdullah, Ruqayya, Zainab, Umm Kulthum, and Fatima, may Allah be pleased with them all. So this was the marriage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam with Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. Let us take a pause over here, my brothers and sisters, and ponder over the allegation and accusation which some of the people who have hatred and spite towards Islam baselessly lay upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And as I mentioned earlier, these are people who do not have information, correct information about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they pick up claims from the society and believe them to be the truth. And one such allegation which is laid upon the flawless personality of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is that he is accused of being a womanizer. Na'udhu billah. A womanizer, a person whose only goal is in life is to pursue and chase women and fulfill his lust. And I call the people who think such about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to question this allegation and this accusation. A person who is a womanizer in the prime of his youth, when he is 25 years of age and from a noble lineage and family and of a handsome build, such that if he sent a proposal to any family, they would be more than ready to give their daughter's hand in marriage. What would be the preference of such a type of a womanizer? Of course, he would prefer a woman with certain physical characteristics, to be of certain physical characteristics, over a woman with a good moral conduct, over a woman with piety and virtue. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the first marriage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was with a woman who was 15 years elder to him. Khadija, may Allah be pleased with her. Not only was she elder to him with 15 years, she was in fact widowed. And not once, she was widowed twice. She married a person who passed away. She married another person who passed away. And the third person she married was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and she also had children with the previous husband. So my brothers and sisters, this clearly points out that the morals, values, the character, the virtue was far, far more important in the eyes of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam than any other things in marriage. And if we look at all of the marriages which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did, and all of the wives which he took in his life, each of them, behind each of his marriages, you would find a particular reason, a far, far greater reason, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam looked at the benefit of the ummah.